Welcome to the Happy Oyster, and today I'm going to be doing watercolor art. This is an example of what I'll be doing. This project is really fun, and if you want to follow along, you can. This is the watercolor paper I'm going to be using. I cut mine into 7.5 by 11 inches. Then we're going to be using watercolor palette. Two brushes. You're gonna want them to be real small, but two different sizes. And either a white crayon or an oil pastel. And a cup of water and some paper towels. Then you're gonna need a printout of your choice. And this is where you're gonna be tracing with your white crayon. I picked the seashell, the octopus, and the hermit crab because I love the sea. Then you're gonna need a source of light. I have a Crayola light tablet, but there are other light boxes you can buy. If you do not have one and you do not want to buy one, I have an idea for you. Take your pen out and a piece of your watercolor paper. You can tape the printout to the window and put your watercolor paper over it. And you want to make sure it's a window where the sunlight is gonna shine through so that you can see to trace out your picture. So now that you know what supplies you're gonna need, let's get started. I'm gonna turn off my lamp so I can see the light tablet better. Okay, so I'm done tracing it. And the reason why I'm using white crayon or white oil pastel is because it separates the watercolors. Okay, get out the watercolors. And I want my seashell to be painted realistic. So I got one of my own seashells and I'm looking at the colors. I'm gonna copy it. I'm using realistic looking colors for my seashell, but you can really use whatever colors you want. Done painting the seashell, and now I'm just going to speed up the drying time with my blow dryer. Now that the seashell is dry, I'm going to paint a gradient of blues around it. And let me make a suggestion. While you're painting, the watercolor tends to go off the paper a little bit, so you might want to put a paper towel or just a normal towel underneath it to absorb it. Thank you. finished with this piece, I'm going to let it dry overnight and I'll finish the two other pieces tomorrow.
It's a new day, so let's finish this project. So now that all of my watercolor paintings are dry, I had a really good idea on how to display them. So come on, I'll show you. So I'm going to sand and stain this board and use it as a backdrop for my watercolor painting. But safety first. Sanded, I still have to stain it with this dark walnut stain. I know I look really ridiculous right now, but I have to stay clean because this stuff gets messy. But I actually know a better way of staying clean. Ta-da! Now that we have the board stained, I have to stain these mini clothespins. And we're going to use wood glue and glue them on the board. So I'll be back. Okay, so we are done with the project. Those clothespins, they ended up being a fail because it was hard to stain in the little crevices and stuff. So we got these metal clips, we spray painted them gold, and we used Gorilla epoxy to mount them. I love this project so much. I had a lot of fun doing it. And if you decide to do it as well, just always make sure to be safe and always clean up your mess. Thank you guys so very much for watching my video. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and see you in my next video.